Everyone knew that there was an epidemic, a fatal epidemic around us in our midst.
Where it seemed like a humanitarian disaster. I mean, we were enrolling children who were just dying at an alarming rate.
Years ago, if you went around, you would see coffins for sale. That was a major industry.
Where the doors are lonely, all day long.
Most of our focus in the early years was on rapid scale-up of access to treatment for adults and children affected by HIV and AIDS, as well as prevention of mother-to-child transmission. We work through a number of implementing partners, including the University of Alabama at Birmingham and their local partner, the Center for Infectious Disease Research in Zambia.
In 1997, when I had a baby girl, PMTCT plus wasn't available. So I didn't know whether my baby passed away because she was positive or negative. The same happened in 1999 when I got pregnant and gave birth to a baby boy who passed away at the age of 3 months because of lucky of PMTCT plus. When I gave birth to Abigail, I went through PMTCT plus and I was very happy. I tested her for first 6 weeks, then 1 year, with the 1 year six, and 2 years, and she was HIV free.
We also support the Smart Care Project, which is an electronic health record system used throughout the country.
In this country, patients are free to go to whatever health provider they choose. That might be in the same vicinity they live in, it might be in a different district. The Smart Care system is based on existing paper methods of recording patient information. The only difference is that the paper records usually remain in the clinics, but the patient moves out of the clinic with a smart card.
The smart care system and the smart care card allows us to track people over time. As HIV is a chronic illness, it is essential that a person's history travels with them so that doctors and nurses know how best to treat and respond to someone over time.
So at the personal level, I've had this hope and self-satisfaction that what we do on the Smart Care Project saves lives. That realization is what makes us come to work every day, and that realization is what makes us motivated to continue doing what we do.
We know that children lag behind adults in reaching clinics and getting treatment if they are infected.
We identify orphans and pregnant women who are not receiving ARV, HIV-related medications, but who should be. And then we enroll them into a six-month treatment protocol. So we're able to take these difficult cases who are probably much sicker than they ought to be because they haven't been on medication and turn them around and then reintroduce them into the public ARV system. We've been able to scale up from screening and treating 300 children to 500 children, from 100 pregnant women to 300 pregnant women.
Well, Africa Direction is a place where we have young people mainly the youth and the children who come here to play and to learn a lot of information on HIV and AIDS. Yeah, so we have HIV positive kids come in and then they get to learn on how to live healthy, how to adhere to their medication. It's a great impact on the children themselves and their parents, because their parents are so grateful that their children do come here to come and learn a lot of things on HIV and AIDS.
To those people who brought PMTCT Plus here in Zambia, I'd like to thank them.
I just want to say thank you for what PEPFAR has done to this child support group, because it has really put more effort and it has done a lot of things for the young people who are HIV positive.
To say thank you to PEPFAR for helping us support the Project Heart program and rapidly expanding access to antiretroviral treatment for children and families here in Zambia. And now as we move forward with a new Live Free project, turning our focus and helping us to turn the focus to elimination of parent-to-child transmission of HIV. Thank you.